In March 1919, two British ships started an adventure to observe a total eclipse in two remote tropical locations. The Englishman's challenge was to prove a mind-blowing theory by a German scientist, which was still unknown outside of his country. The Great War has just concluded, and the world was torn apart. Why did that expedition forever change science history? Five years before, a certain Albert Einstein had introduced his general relativity theory, which proposed that space and time formed a four-dimensional fabric that made up the universe. Massive objects like planets and stars deformed this fabric, and gravity was a consequence of that curvature. This revolutionary idea went almost unnoticed, as international communications were broken during World War I. Fortunately, the theory landed in the hands of Arthur Eddington, an English astronomer and pacifist who became a supporter of Einstein's work. But he also saw that something was missing, an experimental demonstration. Einstein had predicted that the space-time deformation would also deflect the path of light. Thus, background stars' light should be bent by the sun's gravity, so that these stars would appear displaced in the sky zone next to the sun. What was the problem? Hard enough to believe, that jaw-dropping prediction seemed impossible to test, because the sun's daylight blocks out the stars. Arthur Eddington, together with UK's Astronomer Royal, Sir Frank Dyson, came up with a way to demonstrate it, therefore allowing Einstein's theory to pass its final exam. But that could only be done on a specific date and time, during the total solar eclipse of May 29, 1919. The eclipsed sun would be then in front of a cluster of stars called the Hyades. Eddington and Dyson planned to observe the eclipse and precisely locate the Hyades during the phenomenon. One ship would go to Principe Island in the Gulf of Guinea and the other one to Sobral in Brazil. When Eddington arrived at Principe, the weather took a turn for the worse. Out of the 16 pictures he shot of the eclipse, only two were usable. His colleagues in Brazil were luckier and managed to take 8 quality photographs of the Hyades, showing that their position was altered exactly the way general relativity had predicted. Einstein was right. Science would no longer be the same, but neither would Einstein. The physicist became a world-famous icon, and his triumph also proved that, in spite of wars and clashes between nations, knowledge has no borders.